There, they separated, and Duncan returned to the advanced post of the French, accompanied as before, whence he instantly proceeded to the fort and to the quarters of his own commander. And that concludes this episode of Living Room Theater. Not. You know what? I have a really good wife, because not that many wives would allow their living room to be commandeered by an incubator. So here we are in the living room, and Nicki has graciously allowed me to bring in the incubator. Now here's what you have to do, and it's a fairly complicated process, but if you watch an old broody chicken, you know when she's getting ready to nest, right. You know she wants to keep those eggs. She does not want you to grab those eggs and take them out of there. She'll peck you, and mm-hmm. you know, I've never lost any fingers over it.
Right.
It's not a violent pecking, but anyhow. What we have done is we have taken our own incubator. We've done this many times before. We used to have a friend who every year we would give them some fertilized eggs, which means we have a rooster who's
right.
actively seeking
yeah.
girlfriends
okay.
in the field. And what we have found is over the years, even if you go to a place that has chickens, there's always the expert
right.
who says, I guarantee you these are all hens.
Yeah. You get one hen.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Two.
Yeah.
I mean,
not as many as they say usually. It's hard, it is really hard to tell. Regardless of the method they use, feathers,
right.
lifts them up by this or that or the other.
Okay.
There's all these. It's really hard to tell. Anyhow, we got too many roosters, and we need some more hens, and we're getting two eggs every day. Now, we have been collecting some of those, but I didn't have quite enough. I want to do about 18 because we know we're going to get some roosters.
Right.
So our friend Johnny Widener brought us some eggs. His eggs are fertilized as well.
Yeah.
So we're going to take two of our black roosters and have some stir fry.
Yum.
And some other sort of things.
Keep the pretty one.
We're going to keep our barred rock
okay.
and let him run around out there. We have our incubator. Now, you can get the styrofoam kind, and they're very reasonable.
Right.
And if you did several, I think you could put 41 eggs in this. Several batches, it'd pay for itself pretty quick. I think we paid about $90 for this one. It's reinforced, it's got the temperature gauge right here. This particular model has the turners in it. Now you have to turn your eggs
mm-hmm.
daily, a couple times
a day. But we won't have to.
We won't have
okay.
to because we have automatic turners in here. You don't have to open it up. If you get the humidity just where you need it, which is about 60%,
right.
and then you get your temperature up around 99.5 is perfection, 100 degrees, right into the 98 to 100 degree mark, you're going to be okay. And again, if you do collect your own eggs and you want to do this for the first time, make sure over the course of the days you take your, and you kind of tilt your eggs different directions every day or so. Change it up just a little bit. And you want to take the big side of the egg and put that up while you're waiting to put it in the incubator till you gather all your eggs. But anything outside of 7 to 10 days, you really stand a chance of having some duds.
Yeah.
After about 9 days, we want to candle these eggs. So you can hold these eggs up, click on that light, and look in a dark environment, and you can see a developing chicken.
We got a baby.
If it's absolutely clear, you need to get that out because as Johnny and I were talking, and gases can build up,
it
and you don't want that in there, especially in your living room.
Right.
Now, as you can see, there's a little motor right here, and it gently rocks those eggs back and forth. That way, we don't have to reach in there and move those eggs around. It's just this simple, and we'll keep track, and you can watch them hatch with us. These, by all rights, should hatch on my birthday.
Yeah, that'll be nice. That's your birthday present.
And there you go.
Not have to buy you nothing this year.
Now, again, we'll keep our eye on humidity. We'll keep our eye on temperature, and the last 3 days, we're gonna take the turner out. The last 3 days, we're gonna just lay that egg on the bottom of the meshing down there. We'll take the turner out, lay those down. They don't need to move those last 3 days.
Okay.
That chick is getting into position to come out of that egg. Then they have this little egg tooth. It's so interesting.
It's,
we'll show you
cute.
When they come out. So we should have chicks by Easter.
Yay.
And if you can't find fertilized eggs, you can actually buy them from chicken dealers.
Oh, yeah.
You can go around and find next door neighbors or
They'll
folks.
They'll mail them to you.
They'll mail them
That's
to
right.
you. They will. Shipped fertile eggs.
That's right.
But hey,
we're ready.
I think we've got everything done here to have some chicky babies
Yay.
In a very short amount of time.